Yibak says up. Athens Banner Herald, Sunday bus service starts next month in Athens. First 4 weeks free. 2015年7月10日 Thomson Source, Athens Banner Herald, Bwa, July sub. Athens Transit begins a year-long pilot program of much-requested Sunday bus service on Aug. Sublock, kicking off the effort with 4 Sundays of free bus rides, Athens Transit Director Butch McDuffie said Thursday, responding to a continued press by Athens for Everyone, a group that grew out of local activist Tim Denson's unsuccessful 2010 subsay campaign for Athens Clark County Mayor, as well as sustained requests from Athens Transit riders. Athens Clark commissioners included $93,000 in the budget for the fiscal year that began July at Athens Sunday bus service. The total cost of the service is expected to be $36,018, offset by $7,001 in Ferribox revenue. When the program begins next month, it will mark the first time in the Samsatia history of Athens Transit that Sunday services are offered, according to McDuffie. Because the service isn't starting until 5 weeks into the new fiscal year, Athens Transit can offer free Sunday rides beginning Aug. Sublock and continue through Sept. Lock and remain with the program budget, McDuffie said. In addition to spurring interest in Sunday bus service, McDuffie is hoping the free Sunday rides will entice new riders to Athens Transit who will also use the service during the week. That the pilot program runs from 7:45 a.m. until 9:45 p.m. on Sundays and includes 8 of Athens Transit's seven routes: North Avenue, East Athens, Beachwood Baxter, West Broad Atlanta Highway, Barber Street, Chase Street, Macon Highway 5 Points, Georgia Square Mall and Lexington Road, Gaines School Road. For more specific route information, see the Athens Transit website at www.athenstransit.com. According to McDuffie, the initial goal for Sunday bus service is 1,000 plus passengers, which tracks with the current 1,000 passenger per day average for Saturday bus service. I'm pretty confident it'll do pretty good, McDuffie said of his expectations for Sunday ridership, although he also said in some instances, it can take as long as 2 or 3 years for a bus route to build up significant readership. There are, though, some strong indications of a need for Sunday bus service, according to McDuffie. From his office in the county's Multimodal Transportation Center off East Broad Street in downtown Athens, the hub of Athens Transit Service, McDuffie has ample opportunity to talk with transit users, including service workers for the Classic Center, Downtown Athens Convention and Performance Space, and other service employees. They've told me, we really wish you had Sunday service, McDuffie said, leaving nothing to chance. Though, Athens Transit is implementing a wide-ranging marketing campaign to promote Sunday bus service. The campaign includes public outreach at 2 churches, businesses, the University of Georgia and various shopping centers, in addition to print and broadcast advertising and advertising inside and outside of buses. Assessment of the program will be ongoing, but begins in earnest early next year, as Athens Transit gets set to prepare its annual budget request to Athens Clark County's Mayor and Commission, McDuffie said. In general, he said, the cutoff point for discontinuing routes or combining routes is a passenger load of less than 7 passengers an hour. Copyright C. 2017 Athens Banner Herald, Athens, Bwa. Visit the Athens Banner Herald, Athens, Bwa, at www.onlineathens.com. Distributed by Tribune Content Agency, LLC.